Before the famed Stonewall riots, Julius Bar in New York made LGBTQ history. Set in a Manhattan building from 1825, Julius Bar now bears a plaque commemorating events from April 21, 1966, now called the Sip In. Andrew Berman from Village Preservation explained more to WCBS.
3 years before Stonewall, a couple of brave individuals got together and said, we're going to challenge the rules that basically make gay bars illegal. We're going to sit at a bar, we're going to say we are gay, and we demand to be served a drink. And they came here, and they were refused service, and it ended up resulting in a lawsuit which changed the rules and regulations and helped set in motion the Stonewall riots and all of the changes of the last 50 or more years.
Randy Wicker was 28 years old during the 1966 Julius Bar Sip-In. He says that event inspired him to more activism.
The gay movement was my home movement. But I went to there to fight women's rights. The war in Vietnam, I think, was the most horrible event of my life. It went on forever. I was in the first march against that.
Julius Bar was listed on the National Register of Historic Places in 2016. Helen Buford has owned Julius Bar for the last 23 years.
It became my mission that as long as I'm here, this will always be Julius and it will always be a gay bar.
The courage of those early equal rights activists resonates today.
I am drawing strength from this site, because we need to have the same kind of courage that they had.
Julius Bar is open 7 days a week. They say life isn't all about partying and use proceeds to support the American Red Cross and the Trevor Project, among other charities. For Inside Edition Digital, I'm TC Newman.